I am Wanoco, a 3D artist. In this video, I am going to show how to make a material or texture of my sci-fi aircraft with shader node. Shader node is so important, can be the foundation for learning geometry nodes. My approach to creating material is to make them as UV free as possible and have them automatically created as you model them. As a result, as an extension of the previous video, you can model while viewing materials and rendering in real time like this. Of course, this is not a hard rule and I am always looking for ways to create materials. However, I don't like baking unique textures, albedo, metallic, roughness, normal, etc. for each model at all. In this video, the first is preparing the texture pattern. The second is create realistic material with automatic decay effect. And the third is introducing an efficient production flow. And there is a fourth again. First, again, determine the size of the material. I think you don't understand what I mean, so I will try to make an example right away. I will give a more detailed explanation later. Please just take a look. A body composed of such panel is created, and I want to determine the size of this panel. In reality, the panel size is usually fixed, so a large body will be use a large number of panels. In other words, the panel size should be independent of this airplane model. Plan the panel size, then model the plane elsewhere and see the result. This is fun. I showed you a simple example. However, such simple texture are not enough. Let's start with a nice texture. For that purpose, I will introduce JS placement this time. JS placement is free texture generator software that works with JavaScript. It can generate nice sci-fi like textures with default setting by scattering the prepared sprite. And by adjusting these parameters, you can generate textures that are more suited for your usage. I recommend a finer texture like this in 8K to reduce the feeling of tiling. By the way, it seems that you can prepare your own SVG file and use it as a custom sprite. I want to do this in this time, but it can be said to be an effective way to show originality. JS placement can generate colored image in addition to grayscale images, but this time just a grayscale image is enough. Because Blender's material node has an easy to use color ramp feature. This allows you to generate arbitrary color variation from a grayscale image. Not only the base color of the shader, but also the roughness and bump height values can be manipulated by the color ramp. You can also use float curve editing for this, but I recommend color ramp because the result of color ramp reflects the rendering result in operation in real time. There are various texture coordinate inputs, but I recommend the object input in this case. Now the texture will be pasted while maintaining the aspect ratio independent from the size of the object. Texture coordinate object input is not affected by UV wrapping. Therefore, you can model while checking how the texture is applied in real time. By the way, this is an interesting one that works well in my proposed workflow, but of course, other inputs have their uses as well. The material is clean now, but I think it's normal to want to give this plane some dirt. There is a very useful feature there. ambient occlusion node or AO node. AO node can detect grooves automatically this way, and you can reflect this value in your shader. As a result, you can add a dart effect to the groove. So for the dart effect, Blender allows you to use noise textures. The characteristics of this are that it's called pearling noise, so it has a smoothness that splits in 3D space, and that parameters are prepared and can be adjusted. Adjust the roughness of the noise according to the type of dart, and add the noise to the shader. I think this AO node dirtiness is still not enough. So let's design the groove dart using both the value from the AO node and the noise texture values. To be honest, this combination of multiple masks is not very simple. I'm always thinking of a better way. In this case, consider the noise texture as a strength of the dart, not just as a mask. As a result, it is conceivable that the color will change according to the distribution of such a mask. By automating the material, the result is that you can see the effect of dart in real time while modeling like this. Imagine modeling while rendering in this state. I think it's a lot of fun. Also, the materials we are making are, as I said earlier, independent of the model. Therefore, this material can be applied to various models as it is. However, in this EV render, AO interacts with different objects, which can lead to undesirable results. But with Cycles render, you can keep the influence of AO within each object. This makes the auto dart material a really useful asset. Now let's add a new material decay effect. Add dart caused by air current around the aircraft. Given that this material can be applied to many different shapes of models, there is a great benefit in spending a lot of time refining this one material. Also, this cannot be said to be a sloppiness in production. Material decay is a natural phenomenon in the real world. Natural phenomena follows natural algorithms. Therefore, automatically generating decay effect procedurally is not only efficient, but also makes a lot of sense. This material node gets a little messy. From here, I will introduce the method of efficient material development. First, organize your node nicely. You can frame these airflow generated dart nodes. Alternatively, the group function is useful. Group let you reuse nodes in other places while synchronizing the contents. Arrange the input and output of the group this way, and you have a nice new node. With the material node cleaned up, we can start creating another material for the aircraft. Because it follows the procedural method, you can create a new material immediately by modifying the root. It is omitted here for simplicity, but if you use groups appropriately, you can generate various materials by adjusting parameters like Unreal Engine's master material. If you like this material, it's a good idea to put it together in a project that collects materials. You can bring materials from that project using the link function. Furthermore, further materials refinement in the original project will be reflected in other projects. Use it to share materials with your colleagues, and you will be able to create amazing art with the best materials. It can be said that such procedural materials have high potential. Especially, the continuous change of the texture by the parameter is attractive. So, I previously tried to recreate all the matter in this universe with several Blender shaders. it was really difficult. However, it can be said that it is the final goal of procedural material. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the YouTube channel and stay tuned for new videos.